But anyway, let's start it off. You wanted to go first with the gaming segment.
Yeah, yeah. So we want to bring it up. Yeah. Let's talk about gaming. What happened? What was going on, you know, this part of the woods? Nintendo Switch.
Oh, yeah.
They had a conference.
Finally had it.
Last Thursday, right?
Yeah.
It was last Thursday. And a lot of details were, you know, brought out, talked about. And it kind of disappointed a lot of people. I heard that the stock went down.
It went down 5%.
Yeah.
Or 5 points, whatever the fuck that means.
Yeah. The NASDAQ.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Dow Jones.
Dow Jones that got hit. But so, yeah, along with that, they said that, okay, Nintendo Switch is supposed to be a portable handheld.
Yep.
That's also your home console.
Yes.
So they're saying that when you undock it and you want to play, depending on how graphically intense the game is,
yeah,
it's going to be 2 to 6 hours.
That's a big gap.
That's a big gap. I don't like that.
I feel like what they mean is, like, if you're going to game with, like, a real game, it's 2 hours.
Yeah.
But if you're going to watch Netflix on it, that's 6 hours.
Yeah.
But which, yeah, I don't know, though. We don't know. That's the thing. Like, and I do feel like it does rely on what type, how intense the game is, exactly, like you said.
Yeah.
Like, but the good thing is that most of their games aren't that graphically intense. So that's good for us.
Well, that's the thing. It's like most of the games aren't graphically intense.
Yeah.
But, I mean, for that price, I think you should be getting a graphically intense system. Because, like, at the same way, you have a Vita, which...
How old is that now?
That's old. It's like, and that was playing PS3 games. And this, what's it called? And the Switch could play a little bit better than PS3 games, Xbox One, you know? I don't see why it can't, you know.
I know.
That to me doesn't make sense. You could play your Vita for a long-ass time.
Yeah, they have pretty good battery lives, and they have OLED screens.
OLED screen, yeah.
Not all of them, but the older ones did.
Yeah, the new. So.
I feel like there was a lot of mixed reviews in the beginning. There was, like, a lot of people hyped on it on just the tech alone. Mm-hmm. Like, not necessarily the battery life. That's always going to want – you're always going to want more.
What kind of screen did it have?
It doesn't – I think it's just a regular LCD.
But 720, right?
But 720 undocked. When you're not playing it in the console, regular console mode. When you're doing portable mode, it's 720p resolution. Mm-hmm. But when docked, it's 1080p, full HD.
And for you people that think that's bad, like, don't let the number fucking misguide you. 720 on that small screen is going to look like 1080.
Yeah, it's a 6.5-inch screen, and on that size of a screen,
yeah,
the pixels are pushed together, so you can't even tell that it's not full HD. Like,
yeah,
it's going to be fine.
Yeah.
So how much is it?
It's going to come out $299, $300.
Yeah, see, that's the thing, man.
Just a base model, nothing.
What really confused me is during the last 2016 holiday season, I was waiting to, like, pick up a Wii U for super cheap. I was thinking, because they had already said they're discontinuing their console. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, oh, they're for sure just going to want to get rid of these. They got the Switch coming out in March. They didn't do any deals at all.
They didn't do any deals.
Any. I was like, not even bundles or anything. And so I was like, okay, so maybe that's because they knew that there's still going to be that core group of people who just don't care if it's portable or not.
Mm-hmm.
I don't, but for the sake, it's okay. So the Wii U is $250 right now, or something like that.
Yeah.
The Switch is $300. If it can play most of the games the Wii U can, probably all of them, and you don't want to take it out, you can just do that. You don't have to. But I think it is cool. I do give them probably, it is a cool idea. Like, I want to take this on the bus. I want to take this because not everyone lives in the high desert.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people in the cities who can travel with this, you know, on their commute, on our lunch breaks, on their regular breaks. So I give it's – I'm very, like – not really emotionally, but, like, I'm really
torn
between if this is good or not.
Yeah.
And I think the big thing for me is the price.
For $300, that's hard to swallow.
If it was $200, no problem.
Yeah. Even $250. I even thought $250, easy to swallow.
Yeah.
If you need to pick up a game, then to me, $300 doesn't sound bad. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, because you're getting a game too. Yeah.
You know, imagine if it came bundled up with, you know, The Legend of Zelda. Well, maybe not, because that's obviously going to bring more money.
Yeah.
even if it was something, a Wii U remastered game, yeah. you know, like I'm saying, like, hey, this is what you get. It's remastered so you could take advantage of the new Switch. You know,
like something to show off people. Like, yeah. hey, look what this thing can do. Yeah. That would be so smart for them.
Exactly.
Like, we're giving you this game. Show it to your friends.
Yeah.
Like, they wouldn't actually say it, but you would. That's what they would want.
Because that's what people did when the Wii came out with Wii Sports.
Like, check this you out, know?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Look, I'm playing tennis. I'm bowling.
And this is the first console in the last two cycles, the Wii and the Wii U both came bundled with a demo game.
Something.
To right? show off what it could do. This one, nothing.
Yeah. So that's really disappointing, especially coming out $300.
Yeah.
That to me is going to make it be like, I'm going to wait for the reviews, probably wait till holiday to get a bundle.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
But the thing, well, I mean, that makes sense. But the thing is too, around the next holiday, this next Christmas holiday, we got the freaking Scorpio coming out. So,
gotta figure something out. Well, if the Nintendo has to wait, then Nintendo has to wait.
Yeah, that's true, because I want that power.
Yeah.
Like, I want that next level shit.
I want that teraflop.
I want all the flops in my mouth.
Flippity flop.
Yeah. So, the controllers, they spent a lot of time on the controllers. Yeah. They showed off they're like super small.
It's
crazy
it's,
small.
It's really smaller than the actual with the nunchuck.
Yeah.
It's way smaller.
From the Wii.
Yeah. And I don't know how people are supposed to play on that. It makes sense on the screen.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But.
So I'll explain real quick. There's three different ways to play. There's the regular console version way where it's docked on the thing next to your TV, 1080p. You have either they're called Joy-Cons.
Yeah.
There's a left and a right one. You slide them into this little thing, and it's like one controller. That's TV mode. And then there's kickback mode or something like that, where you can set it on a table with a little kickstand, the screen all by itself, play it with the two Joy-Cons either in separate hands or on the same controller, like, or with a pro controller, which look really comfortable. And then there's the regular portable version, almost like a Vita. Where the two joysticks or the Joy-Cons are attached to the console itself. Like, because it's like a tablet.
How? Okay, yeah, because then they have that other little part. So once you have it docked, you put the two controllers, like, and then you have your separate controller, right?
Yeah, yeah. Right. But for those of you who don't know, each controller, so it comes with one controller technically, but each one of those, like right and left, are their own standalone controllers as well. And the thing that got to me was, if you look at them when they're put together, the right thumbstick and the left thumbstick are offset differently, like a normal controller would, right?
Yeah.
But when you take them apart and you're trying to play a game, because you turn it to the side, you turn it sideways, so you go from regular controller or like this to then like this, and the R and left trigger buttons are really tiny for one. Yeah. But also the joystick is either going to be directly in the middle or way off to the right, and whoever gets that, like, it's gonna be awkward.
Yeah, it's very confusing, and I don't know why you would want to get a Switch to do it like that.
Well, it's for like when you first buy it, you don't want to spend the money to buy another controller. You're like, hey, babe, you want to play a game? Let's play a game of Mario real quick. Some Smash, the Smash,
yeah,
like you do. So you give her, you break off that one Joy-Con to her.
Yeah,
turn that bitch sideways. And boom, you got two-player controllers. You got two controllers. So it's cool that it's an option, but it doesn't look comfortable.
No, it doesn't look.
It doesn't look. I don't
know. Until we get it on our hands.
Yeah. You know. And it's going to come with like a wrist strap that you can slide on each controller. And it like amplifies the left and right triggers. Mm. And it makes it a little easier to grip. But I feel like that's a design like fix, like afterthought kind of thing. Like, man, it shouldn't be like that. But to their credit, they did pack a lot of shit in those little controllers. Mm-hmm. So it has a motion sensors. It has a camera.
A camera?
Yeah, a camera. They can read different, like, it can read, like, hand gestures and shit. And they can also measure distance.
God damn.
Yeah. That's pretty impressive, like, what they fit in there. And then, yeah, they have this called HD Rumble, where the demo they showed was the guy holding the controller, shaking it, and it's mimicking what it's like to have an ice cube in a glass and then two ice cubes in a glass. And then it feels like to you as if it's like they're pouring water into that also. So like it's like intensifying the feeling you get, the feedback you get from the controller. I don't know how that really works, but they're trying some new shit, like always. That's Nintendo. That's like, that's what they do. But back to the controllers, they're really expensive.
How much were you saying?
Okay, so the Joy-Cons, they come in the right and left. If you lose one or you want to buy another one, they're $40 each. Mm-hmm. That's expensive. And they're tiny. So
yeah, because a regular controller costs like $50, right?
For an Xbox or PS4.
Xbox, PS4, but that's a goddamn controller. It's not a fucking dongle.
Yeah. So $80 for two of them. If you want the Pro controller, that's $80.
God.
But they're, I mean, if I'm going to get one, that's what I'm getting.
Yeah.
Because I want a regular fucking controller. That's just how I game. And then if you want, because you can also purchase other docks, like for, say you want, like you want to go to the living room or the other bedroom, you can just plop your tablet console into that one and then it goes to the TV. But those are going to be sold separately for like $100 each.
Oh my God, damn.
So it can add up, or you can just be simple, like if you're just that type of dude.
Kind
of
like
just
a portable system.
Yeah, just that's what that's what it is for me. Like, you can do that. But I really think they need to go away from like what Sony did, where like the proprietary shit, like making everything so expensive. Mm-hmm. 'Cause this is, I mean, mostly geared towards the kids.
Yeah.
So you would think, if say you have like two kids, that's expensive right there.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't even include the games.
Especially if you want to just get them another controller and like you said, a game.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
So fuck.
Breaking the bank. That's gangbusters.
Yeah. That's the shit right there.
Yeah.
Fuck, so I still want one, but I don't know about $300, and like those controllers are really expensive.
Yeah, at least for me, this is definitely a wait until the actual reviews come out. See how it plays, how it upholds. I need to see it, and it's not that far away. I definitely want to wait, because like, I actually was on the fence. I was like, if it comes out in the review, and they're saying this is good. You need to get this. You know, good library coming out. It is a launch title. I mean, that's what usually happens when consoles come out. Launch kind of titles kind of suck.
Yeah.
But if it would have came out and been, you know, people raving about it, hey, you need to get this.
Yeah.
I probably would have been into it.
Well, here's the thing. Here's why I was torn.
Yeah.
The price. But if it had all the negative things like it had, but it had like all the games I wanted, mm-hmm. I'd be more hyped. But it doesn't. It has one game that I want. Yeah. It has Zelda Breath of the Wild, which is a launch title with it. That's the only game that's like at all worth it.
I wish it would have made it backwards compatible. That's a big gripe for me. It's like you have probably one of the best libraries of all time.
Yeah.
Like if you would have came out and say, hey, this is my launch line, three fucking games, but hey, you could still play all this other shit.
Yeah.
Boom.
But now on the go.
On the go.
And see, that's the thing. Like they,
that would have been amazing.
They have their Nintendo accounts. Yeah. I don't have a Nintendo, so I haven't made one. Except for the Mario Run.
I think that works.
The Mario Run. No, I'm saying that your back catalog isn't transferable. Like
no, you have to buy on every system.
That's
again.
Fucking that's crazy. So
that's why I'm excited there's about people, that Scorpio.
Yeah, there's people from the Wii, the Wii U, and now this. So I have to rebuy the same games. The
same games. And they do.
And they do.
People do.
But it's not fair.
Yeah.
And speaking on that, when it launches, it's going to have the online capabilities, right? The multiplayers. Mm. Oh, but that's only for a time being for free. They're going to start doing what Xbox and PS4 does, where they charge you. They haven't released any prices yet, but they're going to be charging you monthly or yearly to go online. You'll have like the messaging, all that shit. And like sharing your photos from the games, which is whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know if that's going to help. I don't know if that's going to allow you to transfer over your shit. Maybe not from last generations, but maybe from here on. It'll keep track of what you bought, like Xbox doing, which is awesome. I love what they're doing.
Oh, yeah.
I know they say, like, oh, no one plays those. Like, yeah, but it's still.
People play them.
Some people do.
Yeah, a lot of people do.
Like, you're playing Red Dead, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
See? Like, it's just. There's some games you just miss.
Yeah.
And you want to go back and play. And if you don't want to have to take out your old shit from the closet or rebuy it or whatever, like, ooh, it's right there.
It's too good. I think see stuff like that. If Nintendo would have came out, did that, at least gave me a better battery life. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. 6 to 8. Oh, that's, my gosh, that would have
been. Which is not there yet, though. Which,
you don't think so?
No, we're not.
Look at the tablets, though.
They're not. Yeah, but they're not doing nearly as much.
Really?
They're not.
Like,
how, you know why? Because tablets and stuff, the phones, they stop running apps in the background.
Yeah.
So you can have them all. Not, they're not running. They're stopped. They're not doing anything with that. They're only running whatever you're running. And none of the games on the phones or tablets are nearly as intensive.
Well, I guess that's too. I mean, because I was trying to compare it to an iPad, but I think the iPad does have more power. But you're also paying a lot more.
Yeah, fuck a lot more.
You know what I'm saying? So I guess that doesn't match up.
And the other thing, the only other positive thing with the hardware that they didn't go the PlayStation route was the. It comes with 32 gigs internal storage, which is nothing. But you can upgrade it to take regular SD cards.
Oh, that's so good.
So that's good. So that was, I was super happy to hear
the
that.
The only good that Nintendo did.
Because you can buy those so cheap.
Yeah.
So cheap. Yeah, it's definitely a wait and see right now.
At least from for you too?
Yeah, for me too. For me too. Yeah, I was super hyped, like I'm getting it.
Me too. I was like, and then as for, because we listened to the Kind of Funny people.
Yeah.
And they were like, they're gonna nail it. You know, like they're gonna, it's gonna be good. And I was buying into that hype. And from what I saw too, I was like, dang. But I did hear like the little stuff trickle down. It's like the battery sounds a little iffy. Zelda's not gonna be ready for launch.
Yeah.
They have a Mario, and Mario's gonna be ready, and they actually ended up being flip flopped. Yeah. Zelda is ready, Mario isn't.
But dude, that Mario looks badass, I've been dying to play that kind of Mario game. Like it's open world again.
Yeah.
He's like playing with regular people like that look like us, not weird people like them.
Yeah.
No offense. But like it looks amazing. And I may be able to play that shit and like Zelda on the go, like that's cool, but and you know what though? Like I hear the 2 to 3 hours and I'm like, fuck, that sucks. But in reality, I'm not gonna be gaming that much on the go.
On the go.
Like say you go into Vegas. That's perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect
little buy, and that's what I thought too, because it's like usually when do you need to, you know,
game
but it is like a hassle, you know what I'm saying? Like fuck, I gotta plug it back in, or like, because you don't always plug it in right after you're done gaming, so you might get caught up on that. Oh, you're in a good part, 30 minutes left, you know what I'm saying?
I just thought of what I guarantee you, there's gonna be a third party developer that makes like a battery backpack,
a fucking Morphe.
It's just like, here's your Nintendo Switch battery backpack. It's like 3 times the size of Switch, and it's fucking like 5-10 pounds.
Do you remember like the old Game Boys that used to be like, oh, here's your extended battery, here's your speaker,
hey, it was,
here's your
it,
magnifying glass, here's more buttons.
The magnifying glass was so stupid.
The light
here's, because you couldn't see shit, you know? Oh my god, the,
that's
light,
that's gonna be the Nintendo Switch.
Hey dude,
going back to the Game Boy route.
Fuck, it's gonna be interesting.
But at the end of the day, it's gonna be a fucking table. This is gonna be the size of this table,
just unfolded,
and the screen's just gonna be here. Here's your Bose system. You could bake in it.
Yeah, but I mean, so they for games, they were weak for launch, like we talked about. They have like one called Arms, and then some stupid one like was called Draw, like where you literally, you don't even need the screen to play. You just go back to back and you walk away and you draw, and like the rumble, whoever draws first, the other one feels the rumble, like they got shot. Like I think it's just a proof of concept, like nothing like practical. People were playing it, but like kind of making fun of it, like you could tell during the demos and shit. But I'm excited, but I'm, fuck man, like I want it so bad, but I'm not gonna spend $300 on it.
Exactly. At least for me, it's more Vita time.
Yeah. I want a new Vita. God damn it.
Oh man.
Seeing the Switch makes me want a Vita so badly. A Vita 2.
A Vita 2. Imagine now.
Oh my god.
Fuck.
Even if it's still PS3 graphics, I don't care. I just want a better library. I want all the shit.
Better memory card.
Better regular cheap memory cards, not $120 for like 64 gigs. Yeah. Like, oh my god. I don't know, for like 16 gigs, something crazy. I'm ready for that though.
I agree. Vita, come back to us. We need you.
Come back to us.
We love you. We need you and love you. But I think that does it for the Nintendo, right?
Yeah. At least for now. Well, I'm sure we'll be trickling down news as the year goes on.
Definitely.
Up until launch and shit.
We'll be having our eye on it.
What else you got? You want to go through anything else? You want me to take over from here for gaming?
Oh, no, yeah. If you want. Yeah, that was my big tidbit.
So, continuing on for the gaming shit. Overwatch, they have a lot of colorful characters, a lot of like cool looking,
flamboyant,
like
muscular,
lesbian,
sexy,
slutty,
robust,
tits, titties. Anyway, recently Terry Crews, big old black man, very strong,
good dancer,
very good robot,
yeah,
big ass robot, as he said himself. Mm-hmm. He's kind of a nerd, and a sex addict. If you don't know.
Really? He likes to have a lot of sex?
He likes banging motherfuckers. So he's a banger and a gamer. Mm. And recently he went to Blizzard headquarters and he tweeted a picture of himself in front of the Overwatch sign. He's like, hey, who wants me to play Doomfist? And Doomfist was a side character to one of the main characters and people liked him. And so they're like, all right, let's make this guy another character. And so it looks like he's up to it. And I feel like he'd be perfect for that because he's very charismatic. If they model it after him, he's already built like a superhero. Yeah. So like, I'm down for that. Next we have, some other interesting news. We don't know a lot about it, but pretty much Microsoft is bringing, it's called Game Mode later on this year. And what that does for the computers running Windows 10 and the later released Scorpio, Microsoft's or Xbox Scorpio.
Yeah.
What it does, this game mode, it is going to prioritize all the resources for the processor, the memory, to run everything better and smoother for your game. So you need load times, graphical integrity, because they're gonna be pushing 4K, it's gonna need all the resources it can.
Yeah.
So like if you got like Netflix you just watched and it's kinda like running that in the background, it's gonna cut that shit off. All that stuff is gonna be reallocated to help power the visual integrity for your game. So that's good.
I like that.
I'm all down for that. Next, we have Uncharted 4 news. Uncharted 4 came out last year. Amazing game. Highly recommend it. It was my game of the year. It sold 8.7 million copies.
Yeah, that's a lot.
That's a lot of millions.
For that price too. Money.
Yeah, for a $60 game, like, fuck. That's a lot of chatter. Mm-hmm. Along with that, the PlayStation, because that's a PlayStation 4 exclusive, but along with that, PlayStation 4 hit 53 million units sold. And now there's a difference now. There's units sold and then units shipped. Like Xbox, they'll always say, oh, we shipped this amount, but doesn't mean they sold that amount. Mm-hmm. PlayStation confirmed this is what they've sold through. So that's pretty impressive, man. They're still on the top right now. It's going to be hard for Nintendo or for Microsoft to catch
Microsoft
up.
Microsoft isn't gonna be,
but they're still fucking them still. Yeah, they're still beating them in a lot of ways. Yeah,
for a good while now.
But yeah, PlayStation just had a huge jump start.
Yeah.
Next, Nvidia GeForce it's spelled GeForce. Mm-hmm. It's kind of weird. They're gonna release, I don't know, they didn't say when, a cloud gaming service, and what it's gonna do for like, because like I have a Mac. Right, it's not meant for gaming.
No,
it can do it, but it's not like optimized for it. Mm-hmm. And like, say I had like a little shitty laptop, it's not gonna obviously run like Doom and shit like that. But with this Nvidia GeForce, it's cloud gaming, so you don't have to have the whole hardware side of it. You could just stream it to your console. I don't know how lag's gonna be, but pretty much it makes any low end or Mac compatible for high end gaming, but it's really, really, really expensive right now. Some early numbers are showing like $950 for a year subscription to be able to do this, which I don't see why you wouldn't just buy a fucking PC at that.
900, wow.
Yeah, 900 plus, or like 25, ooh, like $25 for 20 hours of playtime. Like it's a lot. But I get like there's people who like don't want to invest in a machine and then it'd be obsolete. Like, but at the same time, like, you could just keep upgrading for that price.
Yeah.
It's fucking, I don't know. For some, it might be helpful. For some, I mean, maybe just to try games to see if they're even into PC games. Yeah. That might be worth it. I don't know. Mm-hmm. Not really for me, but I thought it was very interesting. The last thing I want to talk about for gaming is the, I have a little more info on it, is the Superboy Retro. It's pretty cool. It's a clone of the old Game Boy. It lets you play all your old Game Boy cartridges, which is really cool.
I saw that, yeah.
It made the rounds on Facebook, I think, for a little while. Mm-hmm. It's only $80. Not bad.
Not bad.
Not bad at all. 2,500 milliamp battery, rechargeable battery. So It's about like a phone as far as charge time. And their games aren't going to be like graphically intense.
Yeah.
So you'd be fine, you know. Let me see what this says.
It's not going to suck a lot of juice.
Suck a juice. Let's see what it says here. Oh, okay. So it's going to be released in August later this year.
Yeah.
So I'm probably not going to buy one because I don't have, if I had like
Game Boy games,
the games, yeah, I'd like, hell yeah. But it's not, honestly, I'd rather have like a regular OG Game Boy.
That's what I felt like too. I'm like, I'd rather buy a Nintendo Color.
Because that's
going to, SP.
That'll hold its value later on. Like, yeah. It's like a relic, you know. This is like, yeah, it's cool that it works, but it's not gonna be worth anything.
No, it's just another little knockoff.
But it is cool to find, because you do run that chance of buying like an old piece of shit Game Boy and not working, yeah. You know. And you might not need that, all those attachments, mm-hmm. like the light, you know. So that's one thing. You might not have to do all the fucking attachments and shit for this new one. But that's pretty much it, man, for gaming.
Yeah, I think we'll do it. Have you been doing any gaming?
I have. What? What's been sucking up most of my time lately has been Tomb Raider, the Rise of Tomb Raider.
Yeah.
The second one that came out. I waited for it to go on sale. I bought it for like $26.
Was it good? Was it good?
Worth it. I beat the first one.
Yeah.
I was like, wow, it's pretty good. Second one, way better. Yeah, like it takes a lot of cues from Drake's.
Yeah.
Which I fucking love that game. But it does, it's like the perfect size game. Like the maps are like, there's tons, like it feels overwhelming at first because there's like, oh, there's this cave to explore. Oh, there's this cave to explore.
Yeah.
And I'm like, damn, like how, like, where's the main story? I'm like, damn, should I take my time doing this? Do I help this villager?
Wow.
Like it does like a lot of side missions, but it has a way of like still guiding you back around to the main story. So like it's manageable. It's not like The Witcher where like you do this and you just keep going that way and you never make your way back.
Yeah.
At least that's been my experience with it. But it looks great. I know it's a couple years old game now, but, well, 2015. But it's still fucking amazing. Highly recommend it if you haven't played it, but that's what's been taking up most of my time. And then that, and then Battlefield and Overwatch.
Oh, yeah? Those are classics. You got to have those on rotation, I feel like.
What about you? Yeah.
Overwatch, a little here. Actually, we got back into Smite.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, that's...
See, that's one of those games I like. Yeah. I suck at it.
But well,
I
still it's a hard learning curve. MOBAs just have a hard learning curve.
Yeah,
Once you kind of get that little grasp, a little bite, you know, everything starts coming together. You're like, oh, okay, okay. And after that, you know, you get the hang of it a lot better. That and the one that we actually been playing more is actually The Division.
Hell yeah.
Dude, that's still in heavy rotation. Well, that's like, cool, you man. Know, yeah, I got back into it. I'm patch 1.4. Now we're on 1.5. We're getting ready for 1.6. Yeah, we got a good little squad. You know, we're boosting people.
You guys need to boost me back.
Dude, you just get on.
But I don't have all the expansions.
Well, you don't need it.
No? Mm-mm. For the Dark Zone, you mean?
Yeah, for the Dark Zone, no. We could run, like, there's still a lot of content.
Yeah.
That you're not locked out of. Okay. Yeah. If you don't have, you could still be in the meta without having all that other content.
Okay, cool.
You know, so you're gonna be good.
Yeah, because like honestly, man, that game has good mechanics.
Yeah, and then the people that we brought back to play, they're like, "Wow, I remember why I really did like this game." And it's everybody that's gone back to it is like, it's a lot better now.
I think another thing that game suffered from was there's just so many games coming out.
Yeah,
like last year was packed full of games
at that time too, and it's crazy because it came out in what, March. And what came out was that Battleborn. It was Overwatch. Which Overwatch was, you know,
killing it.
A monster of a game, you know, game of the year this year.
Yeah.
So that, and then when it did come out, it had a lot of hype. That's why a lot of people did come back because they saw the potential. They were like, "There is something good."
Oh, here. There is. There's definitely potential.
And when it came out, it was definitely buggy, all kinds of shit. The end game grind was kind of rough.
That's what did it over for me. It was the grind. Like,
you got to level 30 and you're like,
I get it. Yeah.
You know, this is not fun. But now they got that loop where, you know, you could go out, you know, if you want to do the Dark Zone, you can. If you don't, go run some missions, loot.
And it's so it's still grindy, but it's improved. Yeah. It's like more interactive. Mm-hmm. It's like you more reward, I guess.
Yeah. And that's the thing too. If you like games where you could like really micromanage to like how you want to build your character, the Division's where it's at. And a lot of people don't know that till they actually play a game like that. And you're like, wow, I just did this little tweak and I see all this difference, you know. So that's why I think, you know.
Because that's usually not my game taste. But I liked what they were doing with that. Yeah. But then, like you said, the bugs and the overwhelming amount of games coming out. Like,
it was definitely funky, but, you know, they're getting they're back on track. So
would you say they should be really, like, that they should release a part two within the next couple of years?
A Division 2?
Yeah.
I don't know if they're working on it or they're just going to keep on building from this one.
Yeah.
Either way, what I did like was that they build this for next generations, not like Destiny. I mean, not next gen consoles, not like Destiny, where it started off, but they also made it for
Xbox
360,
360, yeah,
and the PS3, which held that game back so much. It did. So fucking much.
The development part of it,
Yeah. So that's one thing that I do think that the Division has over. Well, I wouldn't really call it like over it, but
right.
That's like an advantage.
It's a plus.
Yeah, it's a plus that the Division has, that it did start, you know, with on the current consoles. Yeah, so I think working, making that game better is going to be a lot easier, you know.
And like you might be thinking, oh, who cares about that? But when you're developing a game like that that has so many bugs already, when you're cross developing for a different console entirely, like that makes a difference.
It makes a big difference.
You don't have
difference.
To worry about that with the Division. Mm-hmm. You're like, this is what we're doing. Maybe they'll have a little issue with the Scorpio, but that's probably just all upscaling.
Exactly.
Nothing really technically.
Nothing a patch can't fix.
Yeah, a little patch or two.
Yeah, me.
Little patchy poo.
Yeah, that I mean.
Hell yeah, man. I need to jump on that with you guys.
Yeah.
It'll
be a good time.
Run that back.
Run the fade. But I think we're good with games.
Yeah, we're good on games, guys.
Love it.